Hi everybody, I am Katie Scheurer, and if you are just getting started with Esri, then you don't want to miss these 10 key terms that are going to help you get the most out of your investment and communicate with your GIS experts. So key term number one is geodatabase. Now a geodatabase is a database that has rows and columns to store all of your information, but what makes it unique is that it also has spatial relevance to it. So it either is comparing your information with a polygon or a line or a point. And within that database, you can make it more of a personal geodatabase where you have a file geodatabase, or it can be based on a SQL system or an Oracle system and have an enterprise-wide geodatabase that then everybody can edit and be able to use within your system. Key term number two is shapefile. Now, shapefiles have kind of fallen out of fashion a little bit with the GIS community. We're leaning more towards things that are dynamic because a shapefile, once you take that shapefile and move it somewhere else, it's done. There's no interaction with that. It's just kind of a standalone thing. But it is good to be able to share with other programs or to be able to share with other people. You can kind of zip it up and then send it off in an email and be able to share your information that way. Key term number three is a layout. Now, a layout is what GIS experts refer to as a map, like a paper printout of our information. So that is considered a layout. And if you go and ask for an actual paper map from your GIS expert, know that they are thinking like, okay, I need to make a layout, not just a map, because for us, a map is actually an interactive dynamic tool and is not just something that we're going to print on a piece of paper and let it sit somewhere else. Key term number four is Esri services. Now, there are many different types of services and I'm not going to cover them all today, but a service allows you to create a connection to your geodatabase and be able to view your information interactively online. Now, a lot of times that information is directly connected to your database and a viewing capability. So whenever somebody changes something in the database, you automatically see it within that Esri service, and then you can share out that connection either publicly or privately within your organization, depending on what your use is. And that brings me to key term number five, the ArcGIS Online. Now, you might have seen some of my other videos where I have kind of alluded to a lot of the Esri products, and ArcGIS Online is an Esri managed product that allows you to store and interact with your information, with your geospatial information. So you are able to upload your information to their system and then have a wide variety of products between web maps and apps that you are now able to create with their system that is hosted by them. So key term number six is Esri Enterprise. Now the Esri Enterprise includes multiple different Esri products. So it includes the ArcGIS for server, your data store, so your ArcGIS data store, and then it also includes your portal, and it kind of includes Pro. And I like to throw Pro in with Enterprise because that is really the whole package that Esri is providing to us. And with that Enterprise, you are able to take everything that you would use online for that is Esri managed and be able to manage it personally and be able to control it personally. And there are some differences between the two products, and there are use cases where you might be wanting to use ArcGIS Online, an Esri managed product, and Esri Enterprise, your own managed product in your community for your environment. And that is a use case scenario. You kind of have to figure out how you're going to be using the software, how much you want to invest in it, and what your use cases are. If you are getting value out of this video, I would love it if you would give me a little like and subscribe, and also sign up for my newsletter in the links below so you can stick with all of this GIS strategy going forward in 2020. So key term number seven. Yep, we're up to seven. So key term number seven is Esri Explore. Now, Esri Explore is a mobile application that you can use either on your phone or a tablet, and it is a free download to be able to get it and use it, and you can use it with tons of ArcGIS services, but the key way to use it is to link it up to your own ArcGIS Online account or linking it up to your own Esri Enterprise. And this gives you the ability to take all of that data that you have in your geodatabase and serve it up to everybody with a mobile platform. Now, ArcGIS Explorer is view only, so you cannot edit any of the information on there, which can be a really great thing if that's the way you need to keep your data secure to make sure nobody can edit it. But it also gives you some limitations because you can't have that two-way interaction with your information. So that brings me to my next term, term number eight, ArcGIS Collector. So Collector is very similar to Explorer, where it is a mobile app that you can use on tablets and you can use it on phones and any mobile device that you have. And it allows you to get that two-way communication. So now you are able to take Collector, build up your map, put all of the information that you need to, use your ArcGIS services, and build it out so that way you can collect information in your service and in your table. It goes directly to your geodatabase and allows for connectivity between the field and the office. And it is an amazing product, and it's all just a free download that you can use and then link up to your online account or your enterprise account. Okay guys, we're getting close. Number nine is ArcGIS Survey 123. Now, Survey 123 is a product that can use a geodatabase, but doesn't necessarily have to use a geodatabase. It doesn't even necessarily have to have location information in it at all. But it is a survey tool, so it is more form-based, where ArcGIS Collector allows you that two-way communication with your geodatabase. Survey 123 also allows two-way communication with your geodatabase, but it is in a form that you are using. So you create your form, you create your survey, and it is fully interactive. So you can say if the person answers yes to this question, I want these three more questions to pop up. And it has become a very impressive tool. It also is available through the web, and you can use it on your website or other platforms that you want to use. Okay, so key term number 10 is story maps. Now, story maps are a web-based format that allows you to integrate all of your enterprise GIS content as well as any of your ArcGIS Online content and any pictures, videos, or text that you have to be able to make your geospatial story. Now, this is an important tool because it allows you to tell your story with your data. Now, you are creating this information for a reason. You are creating this information to hopefully be able to communicate with people and to create your story. And it is so, so powerful to have that story format. Now, if you want more about how to build your strategy and how to really develop everything further in 2020, make sure that you go down to the links below, sign up for my newsletter, and subscribe so you can see all the videos I have coming up. Thank you. Bye.